We'll start the meeting of Norwood City Council. Today's the last day of February 2017, 2:28. President Mrs. Lake is out of town, so I'm John Mumper. I'm 4th Ward Councilman, and I'm her stand-in. So I try to go too fast, so I'll try to slow down tonight. Just go easy. Okay, we'll stand for prayer and pledge allegiance.
Our Father, who art in heaven, as a body we congregate in this council chambers, we pray for thy divine guidance that we may do all things well, according to thy holy will. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have the roll call, please, Mr. Gears.
Mr. Bonzall.
Present.
Mr. Clark.
Here.
Mrs. Stickley.
Here.
Mr. Blair.
Here.
Mrs. Hanahan.
Here.
Mr. Sanker.
Here.
Mr. Mumper.
Here. We're all present except for Mrs. Lake. So we'll have to excuse the absent member at the end of the deal. I didn't do that last time I did this, so I remembered this time. Okay, amendments of the agenda. I'll let him read them.
So we will remove communication number 4 from Chief Kramer since he addressed Finance Committee. Add the Economic and Community Development Report. Add the new communication 4, which will be a letter from the mayor. Add communication number 5, which will be a letter from Chief Wallace. Move Mrs. Lake's letter to be read before ordinance number 2 pertaining to the safe routes to school. Move the letter from TWG Development to be read before ordinance number 3. Add the appropriations ordinance, which will be ordinance number 4. And add the Finance, Budget, and Audit Committee report.
Remind me as we go down.
I will.
Mrs. Stickley.
I move the agenda be amended as you just stated.
Second by Mr. Bonzall. Any comments? Call the roll.
Mr. Bonzall.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. Okay, we have minutes from the previous meeting, February 14th, 2016. Mr. Clark.
Move to approve the minutes as of read.
Mr. Blair, second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bonzall.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. Request to address council on agenda items. We don't have any requests for that. Reports of standing committees of council. We have
economic
community development and then also finance.
Yeah.
Mr. Bonson.
Thank you, Mr. President. To the Honorable Council of the City of Norwood, Ohio, we, your Committee of Economic and Community Development, to whom was referred Wasson Way and MSD update, beg leave to submit the following report. We discussed the upcoming bike trail and how Norwood could provide assistance for grant applications, letters of support, resolutions, or other potentially creative financial measures. And with MSD, we discussed the current status of claims for the August 2016 flood event. Respectfully submitted, James Bonsall, Andrew Clark, Marilyn Hanrahan, Joe Sanker.
Mr. Clark.
Move to approve the committee report.
Second by Mr. Blair. Any discussion? Mr. Bonsall.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. President. So we, you know, with the MSD update, I was going to go ahead and just read into the council minutes where they're currently at with the August flood event paying the sewer backup claims. So the total claims received was 1,161 claims. This is not just Norwood, but everywhere in our vicinity for the event. So 1,161. Currently in process, so in review by their adjuster, by their legal team, there's 429. There's been 30 denied, so claims denied. 102 have had settlement offers mailed out to the claimants. 42 have had signed settlement releases, and they're just the claimants are awaiting checks. And then 558 have been actually paid out, and that's totaling $2,776,011. I don't have an update on how long it's going to take them to get rid of, to go through all of them, because they do still receive claims, not every day, but I'm sure pretty often. So I'm going to keep checking with them about once a month, and I'll keep the rest of council updated on where they're at.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We have, need a roll call?
Yes. Mr. Bonzall?
Yes.
Mr. Clark?
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley?
Yes.
Mr. Blair?
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan?
Yes.
Mr. Sanker?
Yes.
Mr. Mumper?
Yes. Mr. Sanker, do you have a report?
Yes, sir. Committee report from Finance, Budget, and Audit dated 2/28/2017 to the Honorable Council of the City of Norwood, Ohio. We are Committee of Finance, Budget, and Audit, to whom we report the 2017 appropriations. State need to submit the following report. We heard from both the police and fire chiefs on budget requests. The committee reviewed the 2017 appropriations worksheets and decided to change the temporary appropriations from 0843 EMS by $20,000 to cover the emergency repair of one of the medic units. Respectfully submitted, your sanction chairman, Andrew Clark, John Mumper, and Kenny Stickley.
Mr. Clark.
Move to accept the committee report.
Second by Mr. Blair. Any discussion? Let's have the roll call.
Mr. Bonzo.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. No second. Introductory readings of ordinances. Number one is an ordinance authorizing the Safety Service Director to enter into a collective bargaining agreement with AFSCME Ohio Council 8, Local 914, and declaring an emergency. What's your pleasure? Mr. Sanker.
Yes, sir. I would like to recommend we have all three readings by caption only.
Second, Mr. Clark. Any discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bonzo.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes.
Ordinance authorizing the Safety Service Director to enter into a collective bargaining agreement with AFSCME Ohio Council 8, Local 914, and declaring an emergency. Ordinance authorizing the Safety Service Director to enter into a collective bargaining agreement with AFSCME Ohio Council 8, Local 914, and declaring an emergency. Ordinance authorizing the Safety Service Director to enter into a collective bargaining agreement with AFSCME Ohio Council 8, Local 914, and declaring an emergency.
What's your pleasure? Mr. Sanker.
Mr. President, I recommend that the ordinance be passed.
Second, Mr. Blair. Any discussion? Mrs. Stickley.
I would just like to thank the members of AFSCME for their cooperation and negotiations of this contract. And it's greatly appreciated, and especially with all of the constraints that they have on their budget.
Anything else? I have the roll call.
Mr. Bonzall.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. Second ordinance authorizing the Safety Service Director to apply safe routes to school project funds and to enter into a contract with the Ohio Department of Transportation and declaring an emergency.
But first, we'll have the letter from Donna Lake.
Dear members of council, I apologize for not being present at the meeting this evening, but I am out of town at a conference for my work. However, I did want to let you know about the ordinance on tonight's agenda regarding an application for the Safe Routes to School grant. As you may recall, the City of Norwood, in cooperation with the Norwood City Schools, has applied for this grant each year for the past several years. We choose projects annually in our travel plan that will address needs throughout the city to keep children safe while walking or biking to school. The maximum ask is $400,000. This ordinance will allow us to once again make application for funds to complete these projects. The project that we hope to address with this application involves the intersection of Sherman and Allison Avenues, where crosswalks will be upgraded and entirely new pedestrian don't walk heads will be replaced. I have attached cost estimates to the ordinance that will outline the projects in detail. This will greatly improve the safety of that intersection that is used by many children going to and from the middle school, high school, and Sharpsburg Elementary. In my absence, Deb Robeson from Norwood City Schools is in attendance tonight and will be happy to answer any questions you have or speak to the importance of passing this ordinance this evening. I want to express my appreciation in advance for your support of this project and our children. Best regards, Donna M. Lake, President, Norwood City Council.
Mr. Bonzo.
Yeah. I move that the letter be received and filed and that we invite Deb Robeson to kind of talk to us about the ordinance.
Mr. Clark, second. Any discussion? We have a roll call.
Mr. Bonzo.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. Deb Robeson, please come up and address us.
Well, thank you again for taking the time to review this application and this work. This will be the third year we will have applied for the Safe Routes to School grant. First year, we received $397,000. Last year, $392,000. This year, the project that we would be applying for is $337,000. Those are all pretty big chunks of change that are for the infrastructure for, like, at you know, what was read, the, you know, the crosswalks, the pedestrian heads for this year is all at that corner of Sherman and Allison. This intersection serves about 850 kids, will impact about 850 kids. And that's one of the criteria that they look at is the number of kids that would be served. And then the other thing is the number of bike crashes within a half mile radius. And there have been 27 bike crashes in 2 years in that area. So that's a pretty significant area for us to look at. What questions can I answer for you?
Mr. Blair?
I just want to say thank you for all that you do and everyone that's involved that works with you.
Oh, thank you. There's a lot of people that have worked on this.
Mr. Clark?
Could you remind us sort of the maybe areas or projects that were impacted the first 2 years?
Sure. The first year, now I have to tell you that while we received the grant, the work still has not been done. The work is all done through Ohio Department of Transportation, which none of us really have any control over how fast or how slow those folks move. So the first year, the grant was awarded specifically to do some work around Norwood View, around, I want to say, is it Hannaford? And Carthage, kind of realigning that crosswalk and fixing the pedestrian heads, and then there were a couple of other things right around there. There were some things over at Williams that would help curb the speed through there.
Okay.
And then a couple of things at the middle school in terms of crosswalks and some things that would help curb traffic right in front of the school there. So then last year, so the first year we tried to do a little bit at each school. Last year we took kind of a different approach, and we looked at the corridor from Allison and Sherman all the way down Sherman to Sharpsburg Elementary, and we tried to do projects that kind of fed into that somehow. So a lot of that is crosswalks at each one of those little intersections that kind of come into that area. And so this year, you know, part of it is you can only apply for up to $400,000. So now as our travel plan is starting to kind of whittle down, we have to figure out things that make sense. So this year, this was the approach. We'll apply again next year, probably to kind of wrap up Williams and View. And then the next 2 years, apply to wrap up Sharpsburg.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Any questions, Mr. Sanker?
Yes. We pass this evening, and it's up to the ODOT to come and do the work. So it's just a matter of getting in their schedule whenever they can get down here.
Well, what you pass today allows us to apply for the grant.
Okay.
And then they tell us we find out in May, typically what we've been finding out in July. And then, you know, if we're awarded the grant, then they come out with all the engineers and scope the project and do all kinds of things. But then they actually bid the work out and do all the work. So it is a matter of kind of getting into their schedule and how they're going to do things. So it's a little bit different than other grants we've worked on.
Anybody else have any questions?
This is a great opportunity for us to work together, the schools and the city, so I appreciate your help on this.
Thanks a lot. And your preference with the ordinance authorizing the Safety Service Director to apply Safe Routes to School project funds and to enter into a contract with the Ohio Department of Transportation and declaring an emergency. Mr. Blair.
I move that we pass the ordinance.
Mm-hmm. We have to have the readings first.
Read it. All three times.
Okay. Second by Mrs. Stickley. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Mr. Bontal.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes.
Ordinance authorizing the Service Safety Director to apply Safe Routes to School project funds and to enter into a contract with the Ohio Department of Transportation and declaring an emergency. Ordinance authorizing the Service Safety Director to apply Safe Routes to School project funds and to enter into a contract with the Ohio Department of Transportation and declaring an emergency. Ordinance authorizing the Service Safety Director to apply Safe Routes to School project funds and to enter into a contract with the Ohio Department of Transportation and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Bonzel.
Yep, I move that the ordinance be passed.
Second by Mr. Clark. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Mr. Bonzel.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. Third ordinance, an ordinance authorizing the Mayor and Safety Service Director to enter into a community reinvestment area agreement with TWG Development LLC and declaring an emergency.
But first, we're going to read the letter.
Dear Mr. Gears, the purpose of this letter is to apprise your office that Carpenter Flats GP LLC plans to be the general partner of a residential rental development located in or within a one-half mile radius of your political jurisdiction, and will submit an application to utilize the multifamily funding programs of the Ohio Housing Finance Agency, OHFA, for the development of this property. Carpenter Flats will reside where the current Midwest Woodworking Building is located in Norwood, Ohio. The blighted Midwest Woodworking Building is currently vacant and will be demolished to make way for the new construction of a senior low-income housing development. This will be the first low-income housing tax credit development in the city of Norwood. 100% of the units will be affordable and set aside for seniors. Located in a new four-story building, the development will feature a mix of studio, one and two bedrooms. The proposed development will be financed with 9% low-income housing tax credits, permanent loan financing, and a general partner capital contribution. Development team, general partner, Carpenter Flats GP LLC, developer, TWG Development LLC, contractor, TWG Construction LLC, property manager, TWG Management LLC. Project address is 4019 to 4031 Montgomery Road, Norwood, Ohio, Hamilton County. Number of units, approximately 55 units. Programs to be utilized in the project, OHFA Housing Tax Credit Program and Housing Development Loan. Right to submit comments. You have the right to submit comments to OHFA regarding the project, the proposed project's impact on the community. Any objection to the project must be submitted in writing and signed by a majority of the voting members of the legislative body. Comments must be submitted within 30 days of the mailing date of this notice and received by OHFA within 45 days of the mailing date of this notice. The person to be notified at OHFA and their address is Mr. Douglas A. Garver, Executive Director, Ohio Housing Finance Agency, 57 East Main Street, Columbus, Ohio, 43215. OHFA will provide a written response to any objections submitted under the terms outlined above. Sincerely, Andrea Kent, Development Director, 333 North Pennsylvania Street, Suite 100, Indianapolis, Indiana, 46204.
Mr. Bonzel.
Yeah, I move that the letter be received and filed.
Mr. Clark, second.
Second.
Any discussion? I do have one comment. I'd like it to be filed with a copy of the ordinance so it sticks with there so we can refer to it every time we need to look at the ordinance, because it's something that's got a lot of meat to the letter and tells you exactly what's going on. Any problem with that? Okay, good. And what shall we do with the ordinance?
We have to call roll on.
Oh, and we'll call roll on the passing the.
Right. Mr. Bonzel.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. And what's your pleasure with the ordinance? Mr. Sanker.
I recommend we have all three readings by caption only, please.
Second, Mr. Clark. Any discussion? Mrs. Hanrahan.
I'm concerned with getting all three weight readings at this meeting, and believe we should just take the first reading. I have done a little bit. I wasn't able to get all the information I wanted to get before this meeting. I would like to have time to look, to get more information on the company and what they want to do.
Mr. Sanker.
Question through the chair to the law director.
Mr. Moore?
Just wanted to know if you had any knowledge of whether another 2 weeks would put any hindrance on the financial loan application requirements for these folks or not?
Thank you. I don't know. I couldn't give you a specific date on whether that was a thing. I know that they were. There is some time pressure because of the application for the housing credits, but I'm not. I haven't heard definitively that. Oh no, it has to be tonight, or we won't. That won't come through. I will note that the school district approved this before we, you know, even started drafting it. So.
Mr. Sanger.
Madam President, I,
Thanks.
If it doesn't seem to be an emergency that it has to be done this evening, then it can wait for two weeks. I can withdraw my motion to have just first reading, as long as everybody will be here 2 weeks to finish it up if at all possible.
Mr. Clark, you want to amend your second?
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, if there's no time restriction.
Okay. Any more discussion? Let's have a roll call.
Oh, do we need a new motion? I think we need a new motion to have the first reading.
We did. Mr. Sankers changed it.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize that he amended his motion. Excellent. Thank you.
Yeah. So we'll have the first reading. We'll vote on that first.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Mr. Bonzal.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes.
An ordinance authorizing the mayor and safety service director to enter into a community reinvestment area agreement with TWG Development LLC and declaring an emergency.
Okay, we'll move on to the fourth ordinance, which is an ordinance to change appropriations for the year 2017 and declaring an emergency. Your pleasure. Mrs. Stickley.
I move the suspension of the rules and have all three readings.
Second by Mr. Blair. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bonzal.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes.
Ordinance to change appropriations for the year 2017 and declaring an emergency. Ordinance to change appropriations for the year 2017 and declaring an emergency. Ordinance to change appropriations for the year 2017 and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Clark.
Move to pass the ordinance.
Second on Mr. Bonzal. Any discussion? Mr. Sanker.
Just a brief explanation. It was read earlier in the Finance Committee's report, but the only thing that is on this change is that we're in the Fund 0843, which is our EMS fund. We have a paramedic unit which is down and is actually in the shop. And we had an estimate on having it repaired. However, at the time, we didn't have any money appropriated into the EMS fund to actually cover the cost. So what we're doing is putting enough money in there to get that paramedic unit up and running back into service to assist our fire department.
Thank you. Anybody else? Roll call.
Mr. Bonzal.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes.
We're on resolutions, huh? Or is there a letter before we're on?
Nope.
Okay, introductory readings of resolutions. A resolution declaring intent to sell unneeded, obsolete, or unfit city personal property by internet auction during calendar year 2017 and declaring an emergency. What's your pleasure? Mr. Sanker.
I recommend we get all three readings on this particular resolution.
Second by Mr. Blair. Any discussion? Mr. Sanker.
Yes, sir. I believe we've seen this agreement before, and the reason this is on there is I believe we have to renew it every year, so this is like an annual agreement. So the one we passed last year was obviously for 2016. This is for 2017.
Any further discussion? Call the roll.
Mr. Bonzal.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes.
Resolution declaring intent to sell unneeded, obsolete, or unfit city personal property by internet auction during calendar year 2017 and declaring an emergency. Resolution declaring intent to sell unneeded, obsolete, or unfit city personal property by internet auction during calendar year 2017 and declaring an emergency. Resolution declaring intent to sell unneeded, obsolete, or unfit city personal property by internet auction during calendar year 2017 and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Clark.
Move to pass the resolution.
Second by Mrs. Stickley. Any discussion? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Bonzal.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. Administration reports. You. I'm telling the administration we got here. Unfinished business.
Other requests to address council.
And other requests to address council. Lauren Ratley. Yeah, here, please. So the people at home can hear you too.
Right.
State your name and address.
Yes, sir. My name is Lauren Ratley. My address is 7840 Heather Glen Drive.
Okay.
And I came tonight, and thank you for having me for a moment here, to bring just an issue forward for your consideration for possibly going through your process, and I don't know exactly what the process is. But you may or may not be aware that during October of 2016, City of Cincinnati City Council passed a tethering ordinance for all of the city limits. And I'm here to ask you to consider the same. And I'm here to ask you that for two reasons. First of all, when one tethers a dog in an unlimited 24-hour a day, 365-day-a-year fashion, that creates a public safety problem. And it creates a dog that is frustrated, territorial, and more prone to bite. And I anecdotally know that because I was bitten in the face by a chain dog when I was four, not far from here in East Hyde Park. So we know that that happens, and that children, little children, who are not thinking that the dog is going to have any problem being approached, will be the most likely one to approach them. And the second reason I want to ask you to consider this is because it is currently legal to chain a dog outdoors all day, all night, all year. And a lot of people don't know that. So you call the SPCA and you tell them what you're concerned about, and what they're going to tell you is, I'm sorry, that's perfectly legal, because it is. And although we have cruelty laws in Ohio as well as an ordinance in Norwood, it does not speak to any limitation whatsoever about tethering. So you've got to have a tethering ordinance in order to do that. And there are actually 28 jurisdictions just in Ohio that do have tethering ordinances now. And there are 21 states that have a state law about this. So I'm not talking about a police state that would not allow any tethering at any time, but it would just simply put some minimum restrictions that would be determined in Norwood.
Okay. Any questions? Mr. Sanker.
Yes, ma'am. As far as some of the other municipalities that have tethering type ordinances, or is there anything in specific that they all have in common, or is each one geared toward its own community, or are there specific issues that are primarily needs to be addressed in such an ordinance, or is it just kind of just whatever we want to put in it?
That's a great question. I think it's ultimately whatever you deem appropriate for Norwood, but there are some very good local examples that are already written. The Cincinnati ordinance talks about, for example, between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. So you've got to bring your dog in at night. You could bring him to the garage. You could bring him to the basement. You just got to get him off the chain overnight. There are some pieces like that that actually Anderson Township recently adopted as well. There's an important piece in there, I believe, that says if nobody's home, you don't leave your dog in the yard chained with nobody there to address anything that might occur as a result of the tethering. So there are some frequent themes throughout several of these ordinances, but they do vary a lot. In New Richmond, believe it or not, it's a total ban. So they vary widely. But there's a lot of examples to look at, and I will probably send you a bit of email with some language to consider from some Cincinnati, certainly. Thank you for your time.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
I would just like to say, I'm an animal lover, and I think, you know, what you're doing is wonderful. Would you make sure you, if you're going to email us, you give us your contact information?
Certainly.
Thank you.
Thank you for saying it.
Another request is from Pastor Sonny James, and he said he might not be back. He's dealing with a thing for the youth, as he usually does. And I told him he could record something for us, and we'd just push the button and erase it, but he didn't go for that. So I guess we'll just skip him tonight. Unfinished business. Mr. Sanker.
Yes, sir. We earlier had a finance meeting, as most of us knew, and at the finance meeting, we had discussed the permanent appropriation worksheets, different things that we need to consider looking at to help put together a workable budget for the balance of 2017. And we also have on our plate the worksheets for the recovery plan around the fiscal emergency situation, and that we need to look at on the address there as well. So if anybody has any questions on these, feel free. The auditor is always willing to answer any of the questions, but you need to give a little more attention and thought before the actual commission is seated. That way, if we have some specific things we would like to have done now before the commission is seated, and we can push that forward versus having them kind of tell us, this is what we want you to do, and they have us work backwards. So if we kind of came up with something and had it on the plate and submitted to them so that they can see, well, they already have this, so they must have a pretty good idea where they want to go with this, and then they hopefully will work with us. The other thing to keep in mind when looking at the recovery plan, it'd be nice to be able to dish your way out of this, one year's time, but it took a few years to kind of build up to get into it, and it's going to take a little bit of time to get out of it. They look at like a 5-year plan, but hopefully we can be out of it before 5 years. But I think realistically, if it looks like it's going to take 3 or 4 years, and that's what it's going to take to get through, but we just have to come up with a good plan, stick with it, work it, and put this behind us. So just, I know everybody's pressed for time, but we need to really kind of take a more hard look at it and work this thing out as soon as we can. So thanks.
Thanks, Joe. Mrs. Hanrahan.
Thank you. I've had several people wanting us to confirm dates for the garage sale. We did them tentatively last meeting for May 12th and 13th, and September 8th and 9th. And I just want to check so that we can confirm these and people can get it put on their calendars. They are anxious.
We should probably send a letter to the law department asking them for the resolution or whatever we need.
May 12th and 13th, and the other ones.
8th and 9th of September. Mr. Bonzo.
So even though we don't have it passed, I don't see any objections with those dates, so I'm sure we can probably tell them they can write it in.
I'm fine with that.
Okay. Well, to make it work, though, we have to have
a resolution,
yes. To adjust the fees and stuff like that. Okay, anybody else? Mr. Blair.
I know last week I talked about Judy Dawes, who is going to be appraising all the properties that Norwood owns that are currently vacant or in our possession. And she'll have those appraisals and everything this Friday. And then we'll be able to figure out where to go from there. So I'll get those to Keith Friday, and then we'll see what's going on with all that.
All right, thanks. Once again.
Yeah, one last thing. I've been asked a few times. I know 4 months ago I said that I was frustrated, angry, all this stuff, and that I wasn't going to run again. But I realized that I was being a big hypocrite because I don't know who knows this, but I coach youth sports, and I was telling my boys over and over again how when you're faced with adversity and things aren't going easy for you and it's rough, to never give up. Don't give up. When I came into this, I'm sure just like most of you, I came in, you know, heart full, eyes wide, thinking, oh, I'll just be able to walk on in there and be able to do this, that. Wrong. Super wrong. So I just wanted to say that I'm not going to give up, and I appreciate all the support and all the kind words from current council members and others that have pushed me to do this. So thank you.
Along those same lines, I mentioned a while ago that I wasn't going to be running this year for council, and I'm not. I haven't changed my mind. But the reason is a little different than Mr. Blair. I had promised my family that when I turned 70, I would get out of politics because, you know, enough is enough. I've been doing Norwood politics since 1975. So, you know, you got to give up or grow up somewhere along the line and put away some of those things. And my family's sick and tired of parades, for one thing. And I have 6 children and 15 grandchildren, so I had a great parade group. So maybe I can rent them out. No, but I just thought, some people have been asking me how come they haven't heard anything about me running for council. There's a good reason, because I'm not running for council. I thought I'd better announce it again. I'm not mad at anybody, or my feelings aren't hurt or anything. It's just time to back off. Okay, new business. Mr. Clark.
I'm just wanting to announce that the next citywide prayer meeting will be this coming Saturday, March 4th. I can't believe it's already March, though. March 4th at 10 a.m. on the City Hall steps.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else do business? Communications. We don't need the letter from TWG. We already had that, right?
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Or do we have another one?
No.
A letter from Chuck Barlow, monthly earnings tax report.
To Norwood City Council, attached is a monthly report for January 2017 indicating collections in the amount of $2,406,343.88. This reflects an average year-to-date increase of 58.07% over 2016. Should you have any questions, please feel free to contact me, Chuck Barlow, Tax Commissioner.
Mr. Bonzel.
I move that the letter be received and filed.
Second, Mr. Blair. Any discussion? Mr. Sanker.
Yes, sir. I think reading the numbers there, you know, pretty fabulous. And it's good to see that the tax commissioner was out collecting money this month. However, talking to him today to see where we were today, we're still not quite doing quite as well in February. So, as we all know, things, they go up and down throughout the year, and that's why you really have to kind of put a budget together on conservative numbers based on, you know, kind of glitch in the pan. So February was kind of back closer to normal, but we do truly look forward to these type of numbers, hopefully and prayerfully, continue to come in like this. It would go a long way as to our satisfying part of our recovery plan that we spoke about. So, thanks.
All right, thanks. Roll call.
Mr. Bonzo.
Yes.
Mr. Clark.
Yes.
Mrs. Stickley.
Yes.
Mr. Blair.
Yes.
Mrs. Hanrahan.
Yes.
Mr. Sanker.
Yes.
Mr. Mumper.
Yes. And we've already had Donna's letter. And Chief Kramer. Already had him. Chief Wallace letter.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am writing this letter in reference to the budget I submitted to you in early 2017 for the fiscal year 2017. I emailed my budget to the Finance Committee via T.A. Brown, Safety Director Joe Gears, and the Auditor, Mr. Stith.
Shortly after emailing my budget, I submitted several PO requests, one of which is for the repair of our 2011 frontline medic unit that is currently sitting at Sweeney Ford. Presently, our frontline medic unit is a 2006, 11 years old, and our backup unit is a 2001, 16 years old. This is concerning to me because either one of these medic units